Hey guys, and welcome back. Kind of weird hearing that two episodes in a row, isn't it? I know it at least feels a little weird for me saying it twice in a row. At least knowing that the last time I sat down to record, I actually uploaded the entire thing. But speaking of the last episode, I hope you guys enjoyed that, and I hope most, if not all of you, actually sat around and watched the whole thing. And I actually haven't had a chance to look at many of the comments that have gone up on it yet, as I'm actually recording this the same day that I put up episode 97. I've seen a few of the comments, and of those first few, I would like to apologize to you guys, as I'm sorry, I wasn't trying to generalize. I didn't know you guys actually read the video descriptions, so I'm sorry. So, let's see. First things first, what are we going to do today? Well, I think before we actually get started, I wanted to come back here and show you guys a particular spot that kept coming up in the comments of a place that people were saying I kept missing diamond. So I'm gonna walk back here and we're all gonna take a nice good look around, and hopefully you guys can point it out to me again, the area I missed. It was right in here in this area, and someone was saying there were diamonds in the walls. So let me know if you guys happen to see anything. Because I know right after I saw those comments on whichever episode it was they showed up in, I came right back here myself and looked, and I did not see anything diamond-like. So, I figured I would start off this episode showing you guys this spot and give you guys a chance to point out to me maybe I am completely blind and missing it yet once again. Anyway, I believe now we can get on with the rest of this episode. So, there have been a number of requests that if we're going to be in this cave, then please, please hurry up and go deal with the skeleton spawner. And I think this once I am very much willing to acquiesce to your demands. Just let me get some ink. It's so convenient being right here. But rather than simply run off and take care of the spawner immediately, we will start in the area and get a lot of it lit up. Let me go ahead and jump over to that area real quick, and we'll pick up over there. Okay, here we are. The redstone torch marks our way. Up this way, we have two torches. Not as interesting down this way. This one marks the way towards the skeleton spawner, or whatever it is up there with the dungeon. But back here behind this lava fall is an area that I know has been very dark, and I believe is in dire need of our attention and torching. So, as we head on in and find out that it was just this tiny, tiny little area, and go, well, why didn't I do this earlier? Okay then. Let's see. I'm actually remembering to press shift this time. I'm not completely stupid anymore, huh? Let's just go ahead and block that all the way up. There we go. I feel safer already. Wow, that was okay, not as anticlimactic as I was thinking it was just now. Ooh. Well, you guys know what I say. Always up. And another very quick dead end. It's almost like I wish I had come to some of these areas and checked them out off screen, so that way we could leave all the exciting spawner action to be dealt with. Wow, this is a rather spacious looking room in the dark. And in the light, not so spacious. Oh, hey, on the bright side, we're going to get to that spawner a lot quicker. So, I know I kind of started off thanking you guys for everything that was related to the last episode. And I know I said I haven't read all the comments yet, but what I have received in response to all of the to that whole video so far has been really positive, and I really just wanted to thank you guys for that, especially. That I'm glad I have such amazing subscribers, fans, what have you, that I know that you guys are kind of right there with me and willing to help me out, or at least be supportive of me in these things that I'm doing, and hell, we're getting closer. I think I need to do this so I don't insta-die. Hopefully I can get this done before they figure it out. Haha! I did it! Woohoo! Now no more death from above. Yeesh. Now I believe our plan of attack here, rather than tard pillaring up right in the center, we should instead tard pillar up over here. And see if we can't get a better angle on this thing. So let's add a little light. Head up a little further. I almost wish I had ladders, but I think we'll be okay. And there it is. Hey. Oh, I thought it was iron for a second. Somehow I just knew that was going to happen. Come here. Please fall on my sword. Good boy. Boom. Come on, come on. Show me the... Whoa. And where are you guys shooting exactly? Come on, come on. Shoot your friends. Shoot your friends. Put on a show for the people. You're not putting on a show for the people. You're terrible. All right. Ooh, oh, there we go. There we go. Good job. Good job, guys. Keep it up. Aww. That's. What is this? I take out the torch, and then you start. Guys start. You guys like playing in the dark, don't you? That's it. All right. Now for real. I'm gonna close this off. I'm going to come down here, where it's a lot easier to deal with everything. Ooh, I like this angle. This is nice. Okay, let's continue on around. Oh, hi there. How you doing? Did they just kill each other? That was awesome. Good job, guys. Good job. You are credit to team. Alright, let's get in here. I don't think there's going to be too many more spawning with the torch right next to it like that. And success! We have raided the dungeon! Woohoo! And we had a lot of fun watching the show, too, because, wow. They were really pissed at each other. And now the fun of lighting up the surrounding area. This is crazy. I still can't believe how much of the floor was missing. Wow. I don't think you would have ever found this place otherwise. Just buried here in the middle of all this rock. Madness is what it is. Madness, I say. And here's something I don't know if you guys are aware of yet, but apparently in 1.7 you're now allowed to do this. I have no idea why you weren't before, but you can now finally place blocks and torches and anything else you want on the actual spawner block. Okay. So, can I have my green record back, game, since you stole it from me? I have no idea how long ago. Please? No. Okay. Gunpowder, a couple saddles, and a piece of bread. Which is actually good, because I just now realized I forgot to make the bread that I like to keep in my bar. Okay then. Next. That's a lot of bread. Well, let's go ahead and eat that one. Alright then. This was fun. Let me go ahead and gather up this mossy. And I will meet you guys back in just a second. Oh, look what happened, look what happened. Hi! I'm so glad I decided to do that while I was still recording. Alright. I don't think that's going to happen again, so... Once again, I'll be back once I finish gathering up what's left of this. And holy crap! Did not see that the first time. Yeah. Alright. Back in a second. Oh, never mind, never mind. Stop it! Stop it! Now I see why there was so much bread in that chest. Okay. Let me just go ahead and not say I'll see you guys in a second and just finish this while just sticking around with you guys and talking about how insane all that just was. You know, watching someone else LP recently and raiding a dungeon, I believe it was a zombie dungeon. What the? I'm far enough up to hear sheep? Whoa. Okay. Anyway, as I was saying, I believe they were raiding a zombie dungeon themselves, and they broke a block, and the usual, well, not the usual, but the semi-expected event happened where... spawn because of the whole... Well, I've explained it to you guys before, so I won't bore you with those details. Anyway, I remember sitting there thinking to myself, you know, it's pretty rare that that ever happens, so you never really need to worry about it. And, I mean, once it happens once, you're pretty much guaranteed to be safe, because the odds of it happening even the one time are so rare that, I mean, twice has got to be a near impossibility, right? Minecraft. Doing the impossible. Since, I don't know, a year and a half ago. Well, we will definitely have to do something with this at some point. But for now, I'm going to go ahead and leave it be while I let my brain stew about possible factory ideas. And we get back to exploring a little bit more of this cave, as there does seem to be quite a bit of it left. What the... What do you mean, clank, clank? I just shut down the spawner. Where are you? You're not up here. Huh. Are you down here? Yes, you're somewhere down here. That's interesting. Whoa! What the? Come here. Come here. How did you... Where? What? What? Where did you come from? And now there's a zombie. What the heck am I missing? And he's right there. Hi. What you doing? Evan? You must be coming from over there. That looks pretty dark. Wow, my aim. Come here. You can jump that. Alright, fine. I will come to you. And let you hit me once. See? I'm not such a bad guy. Let me see if I can get my arrow back. Alright, screw it. Didn't even see this up here. Starting to wonder how long it's been there. Hearing skeletons. Seeing skeletons! Seeing many skeletons! Getting out of there! Alright, strafing. I forgot, that seems to work pretty well. I think the other one fell. Ah, poor Skelly. Oh, and he died. Well, to be fair, that is a pretty far drop. One I've made myself thanks to a few creepers. You know, considering how close we are to the spawner, I'm wondering if that thing's just been going super active. Or if there's another one. Wow. Hi, guys. Been enjoying your time back here in this dark area? Yeesh. You know, every time I think the cave's starting to get a little calm that I can start talking about something, skeletons jump out of the corners and they freak you right the hell out. So, yeah. I guess I'll keep things to myself and wait for things to truly calm down. That's a better spot for the torch. Wow. Just in case you guys don't remember the amount of iron we have back at the house, it's currently over a stack of iron blocks. So with the near stack of iron blocks we have in the cave base, I really don't think we're going to be hurting for anything iron for a very, very long, long time to come. Which is great, because that means we've got iron armor for, I don't know, life. Tracks for as covering, I don't know, the entire map. And tools and anything else. Flint and steel, all that kind of stuff. It's like, you will never again want for another item made with iron ingots. And add on that, there's all this iron back here that I've never even noticed. Alright, let me cover this up. That has been bugging me since the first time we stumbled across that spawner accidentally. And proceeded to instantly die a few times. Okay. So. How'd I get up here? I should remember. But I don't. So I'm just going to jump down like this. Oh, yeah. Duh. I went this way. Past the lava. I think I've told you guys before, when recording, sometimes part of your brain goes to sleep. I don't know why. Or maybe it's just ridiculously overloaded with all the fun. No. All the fun and other crazy things going on. Well, I think that finally takes care of this little piece of the cave. So I will go ahead and reclaim the redstone torches on my way out. But if you guys will remember, there's a little piece here around the corner. So let's go ahead and take a look at this and see if I can remember. Oh, yes. I remember this piece. I'm going to, like, put a 10-pound weight on my shift key this time, though. Okay, what the hell? Game. Why am I able to sneak off of full blocks? Alright, thank you. What was up with that? Yes. You guys should remember this area. It's where I nearly died and fell in that. let me put this out. I will feel much better once it's gone. There we go. Now, if falling will only result in my instant death and not the loss of all my items. A far, far better outcome and result. I believe we can all agree on that one. Something tells me this is a pretty small area, too. But still worthy of exploration. Okay. Let us go ahead and finish up this side, which, you know, as big as this looks, I'm guessing it's just another tiny little spot. Mouse, please behave. Thank you. And for any of you guys who are curious, I have not yet ordered my new mouse and keyboard. I'm currently being a cheap bastard and waiting for it to go on sale on Amazon before I buy it. When I first saw it, it was, let's see, what was it, like $75? Which, you know, not entirely cheap, but it's a really nice keyboard set and I would like it. Then a few days later, I noticed it went on sale for like $60, and I've been kicking myself ever since for having not bought it that day. So I'm patiently awaiting it to once again drop to a really nice price like that. Nice. I know we don't need a whole lot of gold, as I did actually spend some time going over the Minecraft wiki and finding out exactly what the optimum booster track to regular track ratio is now. Why do I always hit rocks with shovels? And it turns out that Notch did indeed change things in one of the recent updates. I'm not entirely sure which one. But now, apparently the, I guess, golden ratio, no pun directly intended, is one booster track for every 31 or 32 regular tracks. So that is actually not much gold needed at all, considering that the mine track the recipe for the booster track still gives you 16 tracks for just 6 pieces of gold, and with the fact that we're getting really close to a stack of it, that, well, that should hold us over pretty well for boosters for a while too, I hope. Although, you know, more is always better, especially in this game. And it's weird, it's like, gold was always kind of a rare resource to begin with, and it was like, yeah, it's there, but meh, I don't really need it that much anyway. And so it always seemed like it was everywhere, but now that it's for something actually useful, it's like, well, damn, where is it? Why is it never when I need it? Why is it never around when I need it? Hooray! Forgetting whole words out of sentences now. Ah, yes. This way. I believe what was this one for? I really should have spent some time figuring this out off screen. I do know what this one's for, so let's go ahead and hit that one up real quick. You guys might recall, down here, we busted in on this. I said, hello, dropped a torch, and then proceeded to leave it right the hell alone. So I think what I want to do now, obviously, is find out just what the heck was down here. Again, given the way things have been lately, it's probably nearly nothing, but again, always worth checking out. Wow. Okay, when I said nearly nothing, I didn't expect it to be so literal. Ooh. Hey, That's cool. I left a redstone torch to tell me to come check back here, because it wasn't until I was doing all my off-screen resource gathering that I even noticed the water actually went further back here. Okay, well, that was simple. Kind of hard to be excited when it's such a small and unexciting area. Which I guess, you know, it's slightly redundant. It's hard to be excited when it's unexciting. Yay, talking. I will leave the water since it's most definitely no longer in my way. And I don't recall seeing anything useful down there, unless I missed some diamonds again. Did I, guys? Did I miss any diamond this time? I'm hoping not. Alright, see if I can grab this one. Nice. Alright. This area has been all sorts of interesting. For you guys who aren't entirely sure where we're at, let me give you a bit of reference. This is one of the areas we enter this back area by. Back that way is the other large room that we pulled the diamonds out first towards the end of the last episode, or at least the episode 97. I don't know how far I've recorded once again, so this might actually be episode 99 and not 98 still anymore. But yeah, over here. Every time I was down here resource gathering, there was a creeper wandering around back there, just like, doo 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 doo. I'm so happy being back here. It was like, guy looks just, I don't know, he was just losing the ability to speak again. It doesn't even seem right to personify them like that, but he was just wandering around so nonchalantly, like, I own this place. This is my place, bitch. Don't you even dare come over here. I'm gonna blow up in your face. Oh. Ooh. Well, seeing the creepers makes sense now. I love this cave. This has been the best cave ever. And I know a number of you have been comparing this one to the 404 cave and wondering if. Oh, it goes further back. I've been wondering how it compares in size to this one, and honestly, I don't know. It might actually be nowhere near as big. Or, well, not nowhere near, but smaller. Because I have been watching Good's 404 challenge, and I don't know how far he is, but it definitely seems like he's getting pretty close to the end. Maybe only another few more days in there, and he'll have the whole place lit up well enough to call it done. And based on that, based on those observations alone, it definitely seems like this place is way, way bigger. I don't know about you guys. Would love to hear what you think about that. Scary darkness. Oh, skeletons! That's actually scary. Run away, run away. Let's see if I can get around from this side. You guys might remember here, this is where I was talking about the sirens and asking them to leave me alone. So I'm hoping. Oh! Crap. No, not the way around, not the way to sneak around, not at all, no.